First edition, Schofield Reference Study Bible, King James Version, Psalm 72, a psalm for Solomon, verse 9. Then that dwell in the wilderness shall bow before him, and his enemies shall lick the dust. Now, as I and I, Ras Tefri, had, previously reasoned on one of these, audio vids, that verse in its, full truth, in the fullness of it, in its holiness, would read, "And Ethiopia shall prostrate before the face of God before him, and his enemies shall lick the dust, the dirt, the soil." You know, take your pick. Anyways, so going on forward, we know that this is true and exact. You know, we know that God is not a man that he should lie. Rather, God is, as I and I, God and Father, the first power of the Trinity, and lives and will always live a life of truth. And thus, you know, we can be confident and trust that the word handed to us via through the Book of the Seven Seals, the Metzhav Kiddush, 1961, authorized, revised, Royal Amharic Bible, you know, that water from our own well, our own scriptures, and accurate our scriptures are of a truth. Let that be well known, you know, so that the knowledge of him fill this earth so badly stained with corruption and you know, confusion. But nonetheless, that's a whole different matter. Now, going on forth, we just want to make mention that, you know, even at times when we have established truth to be, it doesn't hurt I and I to further strengthen that knowledge. As a matter of fact, it would work towards our advantage. It would allow us to more freely trust in that word and display and you know, put into practice a more secure, a more strengthened and freely display that confidence in that word of truth, you know. So, you know, more strength to I and I. If it be possible, you know, and in this case it is possible, we just happen to note a minor detail, it would seem, right? But still, quite significant, so that we might share with all the Ivan. Now, it's not to say that we're trying to prove this to anyone, but, you know, like we said, just strengthening the case only builds our faith that much more, you know, that we may freely speak that which is just and exact. So now we're actually going to go to, well, reference. This is the Reina Valera, 1909. I guess it says classic Bible with references. This is, I guess, Queen Valera's 1909 authorized, revised version of the Bible. It is highly used among the Spanish-speaking audiences. We're not so sure if individuals actually read it, but nonetheless, it is well recognized within the Spanish community. And, well, not Spanish in the sense of coming from Spain, but, you know, Spanish speakers. Now, Psalm 72, verse 9 actually reads, "Delante de él postrarán los etíopes, delante de él postrarán los etíopes, y sus enemigos lamerán la tierra." Delante de él, you know, before him, se postrarán, shall prostrate los etíopes, the Ethiopians, and Jesus and his enemigos, enemies, lamerán, lick la tierra, the earth. So, kind of like la tierra, itria, in a sense. I mean, there's something there, but that's like kind of going off topic. Well, that's basically what we wanted to make mention. I mean, you know, King James Version Bible actually reads, "And them that dwell in the wilderness shall bow before him," but you know, just to fill the earth with the full knowledge of him, his majesty in and through Jesus Christus, even the version Queen Valera 1909 confirms, you know, that the that our scriptures, the Rastafari Bible, the Book of the Seven Seals mentioned in the Book of Revelations, chapter 5, verse 5, you know, this version, Spanish version, testifies to the accuracy within the revised scriptures, you know, that I and I, God and Father, have so gracefully produced for I and I. And so we just wanted to share that with all, you know. In some cases, it turns out that the Spanish version authorized by Queen Valera is actually somewhat more accurate than the King James Version. Not in all cases, but as we have shown, it makes we think and makes us want to go study this a little more. So yeah, and I guess just some, like, for those interested, this one was actually authorized before the King James Version, although, and this is only an assumption, but due to the fact that it's Queen Valera, maybe that's the reason it wouldn't get all that much attention, but that's just speculative. So, you know, with that, we hope that this helps and benefits the Rastafari community, as we are sure it will the human community. So, shalom, Rastafari.